Welcome back. Previously, we have taken a look at single value converters, which help you to convert a value of one type to a value of another type. But there are often situations where you need to pass multiple values to a single converter and get a value of another type. For instance, if you want to return true when some text contains another text, you will need to pass two values to the converter, such as the text that you want to search and the text where you want to search. And here is where you need to know how to work with multi-value converters. So let's start by adding an additional row to our main window. So open up MainWindow.xaml, an additional row to our outer grid of auto height, and I will copy the last group box and change it as I need it. So it will be in grid row 3. I will name it contains string multi-converter. The background will be something brown, like burly wood. And inside we will have four columns for two text blocks and two text boxes, like this. The first one will be search. I'll name this text box to db_search. Then we will have again a text block, grid column 2. The text will be just content. And again we will have a text box in grid column 3. The name will be db_content, and the text is going to be just test white space content. And now we will create a new converter. So right click on your project, select add and new class. I'll name the converter contains string multi converter. Unlike single value converters, which derive from iValue converter, this one is going to be derived from iMultiValue converter. Press Ctrl dot and include using system Windows data. This interface requires implementation, so press Ctrl dot and hit implement interface. So again, unlike single value converters, which have just a single object, these ones have it as arrays, and this allows us to use multiple values. So the first value is going to be string. I'll name it text to contain. It will be equal to values 0 converted to string. And also I will have another string for container text, where we will search this string. So it will be values 1 converted to string. So of course we can work with any number of values, but for simplicity I will work with just 2. So we will check if text to contain is equal to string empty, we will just return false. But if it's not, we will check if container text converted to lower contains text to contain, also converted to lower, we will return true. So if we type in search this or this, both of them will be found in this string. But if it's not the case, we return false. So if, for instance, we search for a string QC and it's not here. Okay, now save it. And we can get back to our main window. First of all, let's rebuild it. Now, at the end, we will add new local contains string multi-converter. X key is going to be the same but lowercase, like this. Let's copy this name and get back to this text box. So I will add a style to this text box. So text box, not text, but style. And inside again, style target type text box. So so that we can see its properties. And I will access style triggers. We actually need a data trigger, which will work when its conditions are true. So value equals true. So here we need to use data trigger binding, and we will use multi binding with the converter. So open curly braces, type static resource, and put the name of the converter. So inside we will bind two times, so binding element name, this one db search. So we will bind first to the text that we are going to search, and the path is going to be text. And the second binding, I list the second value passed to this converter, is going to be the text of this very same text box. So we will need to use relative source, again open curly braces and type relative source, and type self. And the path is going to be text. So if this is true, we will set such a property background to gold color. Now let's check it, press F5. So if I type something that is not here, it's not gold. But if I type something that is here, like letter E, it will be gold. So test, and then for example Q, it's not gold. But test, which is inside this string and converted to lower, as well as this one, of course it will be gold. So that's how you use binding when you pass values from XAML elements. But if you, for example, want to pass a value from your C# property, you will have to do a bit more work. So go to backend, and let's add a new property, public string, for example, search text, getter and setter, and by default it will be equal to string empty. I use it so that our converter does not work with a null object, which will cause an exception. Okay, so here we will bind not to an element, but to a property called search text that we have just created. And I will use the same property for this text box text property. So in curly braces, binding, and here. And absolutely necessary, set update source trigger to property changed, because otherwise it will not update. Now, to save us some time, I will again install a 4D property changed NuGet package. So in browse, type 4D and select property change.4D. Install, and again accept the license that will come up. Okay, now that it is installed, again go to backend, and we need to derive our window from an interface called iNotify property changed. Press control dot and include the namespace. This interface also requires implementation, so press control dot and hit implement interface. Okay, let's move it up here, and now we can launch our program again. So it's not in this string, but for example TE is in this string. So as you can see, working with C# properties is just as easy as working with XAML elements. So again, multi-value converters are used when you want to pass two or more values to a converter and get a value of the same or another type. So thanks for watching, and if this helped you, please subscribe, and see you later.